Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
Acts chapter 3, verse 19.
Read it.
Repent ye therefore and be converted. So God says, Misha, to repent therefore and be converted. Do you know what converts us? Well, what does the word convert mean?
Y'all ask me questions about them big black snakes.
Say it again.
That brother,
what does the word convert mean?
Oh, ain't true, huh? Niggas sending big pics and they ain't gonna know. Sending big pics to another man.
That's what it is. It means to change. But to change into what?
Don't let me leave that out. They leave it with
something like that. Yeah, exactly. Change a negative to a positive, right? This right here is a negative. 71st and Jeffrey right now is a negative. This is a miss of sin right here. Brothers out here selling cigarettes, selling blunts, weed, all right? Out here leaning over heroin and stuff. That's a negative. That is sin. This right here is darkness. God did not call us to this. Christianity called us to this, but God did not call us to this.
That's right.
Psalms chapter 19, verse 7. So what we're about to do, we're about to find out what converts us. Because the scripture says, repent ye therefore and be converted. Now we're going to find out how to be converted. The law of the Lord is perfect. The what? The law of the Lord is perfect. So the scripture says that the laws of God are perfect. You understand that? If something is perfect, would you ever get that, get away with that? So when Christianity says that the laws of God are done away with, does that sound like sound doctrine? You said it sounds like sound doctrine? No, it doesn't, but it's right. It's perfect. Why would you get rid of something perfect? Read. Converting the soul. Well, what? Converting the soul. Repent ye therefore and keep the commandments. It converts your soul. It changes you. It changes the way you think, the way you behave. If you want to respect yourself, you have to keep the commandments of God. You understand that? Go back. Acts chapter 3. Acts chapter 3, verse 19.
Bring it out.
Repent ye therefore. So, what are we out here teaching? Repentance. Brother, you're an Israelite, whether you believe it or not. God is calling. Repent ye therefore and be converted. And be converted. Meaning what? Keep God's commandments. Read. That your sins may be blotted out. In order for our sins to be blotted out, we must repent and keep God's commandments. You do not get sins blotted out by adding sin on top of sin. You're just adding more sin on top of sin, pretty much. I mean, it don't get no more basic than that. Right? Read. That your sins may be blotted out. When the time of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. Do you have an idea what the time of refreshing of the presence from the Lord is? Come here. Let me ask you. Do you have an idea what that's talking about? Read it again. Repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out. So we read the scripture, repent ye therefore and be converted. All right? Then we read another precept to explain converting, which is keeping God's law. So what he's saying is repent and keep the commandments, right? Read. That your sins may be blotted out. When the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. What you think that's talking about? The time of refreshing. I'm going to show you what it's talking about. 1 Peter 3 and 7. What is the times of refreshing of the Lord? This earth right now is defiled. Right. This is all defiled. God did not call us to this. Let me ask you a question. When in Genesis, when everybody was wicked, what did God do? He killed everybody. He flooded the earth. He refreshed the earth. He restored it, right? God is going to do it again.
That's right.
But if you want to be delivered like Noah and his three sons and their wives, you have to keep the commandments of God. Read 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 7. But the heavens and the earth, which are now, talking about the kingdoms, which are now America, Spain, Switzerland, Germany, Great Britain, read, by the same word are kept in store. By the same word, meaning what? The Bible are kept in store, read. Reserved unto fire. Matter of fact, jump up a little bit higher because it mentions Noah. First Peter chapter 3, verse 4. And saying, where's the promise of this coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation. And people say that, don't they? They say, where is Christ? People were saying Christ been coming all day long. My mama been saying it, my grandmama been saying it, my great-grandmama been saying it. When is the time going to come? Christ ain't came back yet. Man, that stuff is garbage. That's what people say, right? Verse 5. For this they willingly are ignorant of. God says, for this they willingly are ignorant of. They are thereof. Because they say, since Christ ain't come, man, that stuff is bogus. It ain't real. He ain't never going to come back. So I'm just going to do what the heck I want to do. They willingly ignorant. Read. That by the word of God, the heavens were of old. And the earth standing out of the water and in the water. See, that said earth standing out of the water and in the water. He's referencing the time of Noah when he flooded the earth. Read. Whereby the world that then was being overflowed with water perished. See, that says, by the times of old, it being overflowed with water, it perished. It's referencing by the, it's referencing when the Lord flooded the earth. Everybody was wicked, he flooded the earth and killed them. He refreshed it. Read. But the heavens and the earth, which are now. So now it says, but the heavens and the earth, which are now, today, read. By the same word that Noah taught, read, are kept in store.
They are kept in store for what?
Reserved unto fire by nuclear warfare. That's what the Bible is talking about, and we're going to get it too. Read, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. Perdition of ungodly men. Those that refuse to keep God's commandments. But guess what? God is calling you. God is calling you. God is calling you. Believe it or not, if you repent and keep God's commandments, you will be preserved from that day. You will not have to feel that hellfire. Read. But beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years. So the scripture says that one day with the Lord is of the time of 1,000 years. That's why we think like, man, this stuff is forever. It takes so long. Because time, the Lord doesn't experience time the way we do. So when he says, lo, I come quickly, he means that thing. He does mean he come quickly. Read. And 1,000 years as one day. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness. So some of us, we may count as slackness, Marie, but it's long-suffering to usward. He's what? Long-suffering to usward. He's long-suffering to usward. Why? Because he wants you to repent first. He's up to destroy the earth and kill all his children too. He's waiting for you to repent. Read. Not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance, all the elect. Read. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night for those that don't prepare themselves. Right now, we're teaching you to prepare yourself. Sister, you got to keep the commandments. What's the question? About the image of the beast? Oh, okay. Okay. So, read that part again for me. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night. So the scripture says that the day of the Lord is going to come as a thief in the night. A thief, do you prepare for a thief? Nah, you don't. So we ourselves, us keeping God's commandments, keeping the Sabbath day holy, keeping the Passover, keeping this new moon. All right, sisters dressing modestly. All right, read on. It's us. Sorry, that's us preparing ourselves. The ones that's gonna come like a thief for tonight to others. Why? Because they didn't listen. They were unprepared. Read. In the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise. Shall pass away with what? A great noise. Boom. That's what it's talking about. Nuclear fire. Back then, they didn't understand that because the technology wasn't developed. Today, now we have to understand it. What is going to make the heavens or destroy things with a great noise? What exists like that? Nukes. Atomic bombs. That's what's going to happen. Read. In which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise. And the elements shall melt with fervent heat. And the what? And the elements shall melt with fervent heat. What the hell exists today that's going to make us pass away everything with a great noise and melt all the elements? Nuclear bombs. That's what the day of judgment is coming. That's the time of refreshing. When the Lord gets rid of all the wicked and he preserves his children, the righteous, those that repent and keep his commandments. Read on. The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. And the works that are therein. What are some of those works? Technology that turns a man into a woman, that's going to be burned therein. Drugs that got our people hooked and leaning out here, that's going to be burned therein. You understand that? Wicked men and women shall be burned therein. And if you don't want it to be y'all, repent and keep the commandments, or you're going to burn therein. You understand that? Give me Malachi 4:1. Let's dive into this some more. Because some of us might just have to put the fear of God into you before you repent. Come on. Malachi chapter 4, verse 1. For behold, the day coming that shall burn as an oven. We just read that in 2 Peter's, right? Malachi said, behold, the day coming that shall burn like an oven. Read. And all the proud, yeah, and all that do wicked shall be stubble.
They shall be what?
Be stubble.
They shall be stubble.
You're going to be nothing but dust. All because you didn't want to keep the commandments of God. It's not that hard to keep your legs closed and only open it for your husband. That's not hard. It's not hard for a man to keep his rod in his pants and only deal with one woman. That is not hard. But the white man taught you that, nah, you ain't got to do that. In fact, here's a condom for you, and you can stick your rod into anything. That's because the white man is of the devil. He's of Satan. Is that it on that? And the day cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch.
It shall leave neither root nor branch.
Everything is going to be destroyed. Even the Black Lives Matter movement is going to be destroyed, which is a sodomite movement. Black Lives Matter does not care about black lives, believe it or not. Believe it or not. If you read their mission statement, their mission statement has nothing to do with protecting black lives. Their agenda is to push transsexual agenda. They want black men out of the households. They literally say this. They want black men out of the households. And if he is going to be in a household, it should be with another man, woman with woman, or transgender with other transgenders. That's what their mission is. That's what it is. Read on. Behold, I have created the smith. So God says, behold, I have created the smith. What does a smith do? He's an artificer of iron, right? He makes weapons. God says, behold, I have created the smith. Read. That bloweth the coals in the fire. Why? Because they make weapons. Back in the day, you had smiths, right? You still got smiths today, but back in the day, it was mostly swords, it was iron, axes, things of that nature, right? But watch this, read. And bring it forth an instrument for his work. Bring forth an instrument for his work, right? Read. And I have created the waster. Now he says, I have also created the waster. What is that waste? You know what that's talking about today?
scientists.
Right.
Scientists. Those that developed the nuclear bomb, those are the wasters. All right? When Einstein finished it, finished his work, he said, I have become the god of death. Read. And I have created the waster to destroy. What? To destroy. What is that that exists that is wasting things and can destroy? A nuclear bomb. A nuclear bomb. That's what it's going into. God said, I have created the waster. The scientists to develop that in order to destroy them. That's what he's going to bring forth his wrath on them. So what are we going over? The judgment of God. The refreshing of God. Which all of us are going to endure if we do not repent and keep God's commandments. In fact, these brothers as well, they will endure it if they don't repent and keep God's commandments. Read Isaiah chapter 34, verse 4. And all the host of heaven shall be disarmed. Let me start at verse 1. Verse 1. Come near, ye nations. So God says, come here, you nations, you white man, you Chinese man, you Arab man, you East Indian man. Read. To hear. And hearken, ye people, let the earth and all that is therein, the world and all things that come forth of it. For the indignation of the Lord is upon all nations. It is what? The indignation of the Lord is upon all nations. So God says, the indignation of the Lord is upon all nations. And of you children of Israel, that hear the sound of my voice. Read. And his fury upon all their armies. He hath utterly destroyed them. He hath delivered them to the slaughter.
He hath what?
Delivered them to the slaughter. Because some people think that God is just love, love, love. No, God is a man of war and judgment. And if you don't keep his commandments, you are going to be falling victim of God's indignation. Read. Their slain also shall be cast out. Verse 4. And all the host of heaven shall be disarmed, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll. So it says, all the host of heaven shall dissolve. It's not talking about a space. It's talking about the kingdoms here. Heaven is a condition. All right? So it says, all the heavens shall dissolve. Read, just like we read in 2 Peter, just like we read in Malachi 4. Read, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll. Want to roll together like a scroll. I don't know if you've ever seen a video of when a nuke or a bomb drops, but once it explodes, it rises, the fire rises up, and the smoke rolls. They call it a mushroom cloud. It looks like a mushroom. Read that part again. And the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll. God says the heavens are going to be rolled together as a scroll. Now that's documented in the Holy Bible. Can you believe that? That's actually documented in the Holy Bible. The same book that our people aimlessly say, oh, that was written by the white man. That ain't nothing. That's garbage. No, God has the destruction of the white man written in this book.
That's right.
Read. And all their hosts shall fall down. As the leaf falleth off from the vine. It says, all their hopes shall fall down as a leaf from the vine. Talking about what? The satellites that they have in the space. He just started implementing a space force where they can go to war in space, like on some Star Wars type stuff. They really think they're going to fight against God. But read on. And as a falling fig from the fig tree, for my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea. It shall come down upon who? Idumea. Idumea. Who is Idumea? Idumea is a Greek term for the word Edom. Edom means red. Who is the red man on the earth? The so-called white man. His sword, his indignation is going to be bathed in America. His sword and his indignation is going to be bathed in Great Britain. Bathed in Germany. Bathed in Spain. Bathed in Rome. All right, you understand that? Bathed in friends. Read. For my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea and upon the people of my curse to judgment. See that? You see what God called them? The people of his curse to judgment. The people of his curse. Proverbs chapter 28, verse 9. He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law, even his prayer shall be abomination. God says, he that turneth his ear from hearing the law, even his prayer shall be an abomination. What verse 13 says? Verse 13, he that covereth his sins shall not prosper. So God says, he that covereth his sins, you're not going to prosper. You know what it means to cover your sins? What does it mean?
To you Christian Israelites, you fake Israelites, but you are not in the truth. You are not a real priest and prophet of the Lord. You don't even have a goddamn headpiece on.
No, the Bible says, watch this, read it again. Proverbs chapter 28, verse 13. He that covereth his sins, scripture says, he that covereth his sins, if I'm trying to cover something, I'm trying to hide it. I'm trying to hide my sins. God said, what? He that covereth his sins shall not prosper. Meaning what? If you try to make excuse for keeping God's commandments or not keeping God's commandments, God says you're not going to prosper. It's not going to happen. Read. But whosoever confess, they pray to the Lord, and they acknowledge their sin, they confess it, read, and forsaketh it, or repent, read, shall have mercy. That's how you're going to get mercy, sis. That's how you're going to get mercy. It's not just saying, oh, Lord, please forgive me for my sins, and then you keep on and keep doing it again. That's not in the Bible. God says you have to confess it and forsake them. But it's impossible for you to confess your sins if you don't know what sin is and you don't even know what sin you're in. Which means what? You have to study the Bible.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.